Hello, Yahtzee here. I'm at E3 because of sins I committed in a former life. We're at the Microsoft Showcase on day minus one, and we're going to take a look at some things and put our hands on them. This must be what it's like to be a third-person game character. Right, I'm seeing Age of Empires 2 and 4 are up there, so that's presumably the half of the stage for lame-os. Ah. Is that thing that wasn't Overwatch? I asked the guys I was with, like, 5 minutes ago, do you remember what that game was that's like Overwatch but not? And no one could remember. Well, it's this thing. Bleeding Edge, it's called. Okay, I'm talking to...
Henry Falconer.
Who is the lead programmer on Bleeding Edge. So why don't you tell us a bit about it before we get started?
Yeah, so it's a 4v4 melee online multiplayer game.
So it's just melee?
Yeah, there's ranged fighting as well.
So I'm seeing a lot of the Overwatch-y sort of influence.
Yeah, we've been compared to Overwatch before, but we think we're something unique. Overwatch is much more of a shooter. We think that our game has a bit more of a unique style.
Right. So I was wondering this all day, but what is it with AAA games and Magenta these days? Played a bit of that Bleeding Edge. It's two teams of four. Well, they kept saying it was melee, although there was ranged characters, although admittedly it was mainly melee, I guess. Funny, every character was like an Overwatch character with a different spin on it. Like, I was playing like a dude who was a DJ bloke, who was the same as the DJ bloke from Overwatch. And there was a small cute girl with a big machine gun, and there was a cowboy. I think there was a Reaper sort of bloke as well. But, worth noting was that while standing on a capture point, I got creamed by a speeding train. Twice. So there's that. I mean, I never saw that in Overwatch. Only in Team Fortress 2. Ooh, nothing new under the sun. They're showing that new Minecraft game again. Remember when they tried to make Silent Hill into a Gauntlet-like game? I was suddenly reminded of it. Queuing up for some Gears 5 now. Yeah, it looks like they're just doing the multiplayer mode. The new escape multiplayer mode that they made a big thing of at the conference. I'm seeing a choice of three characters. There's one hairy man, one butch lady, and one other. Right, I'm seeing from here that the escape round apparently starts with all three players pulling a sort of Tommy Lee Jones in Men in Black sort of gambit in order to infiltrate an alien hive. So how many Gears of War games do you go inside an alien hive? All of them? I'd be interested to see some of the campaign of Gears of War 5, because I suspect it would be very, very boring and much like campaigns of previous Gears of War games. Oh, have you seen that? The hive's underneath us. They showed us that. That's where those gaming celebrities were. You know, I'd be impressed if they actually set up an actual escape room down there. Oh, it looks like Borderlands 3 at the back as well. Probably a shorter queue, but where the fuck are we got to be, eh? Someone else has the key to the Airbnb. We're stuck here for 3 hours. Making noise for noise's sake. I guess that's the whole point of this show, isn't it? It's Left 4 Dead, but it's Gears of War. Gears of Dead, or Left 4 War.
This is Cyber Shadow.
Yes.
It is made in the vein of similar, like, classic 8-bit games, Ninja Gaiden, a little bit of Mega Man X, and primarily it is a side-scroller that you're going to be jumping around and slashing things and being a cool ninja in a cyber age.
All right, can't say fairer than that. Played a bit of Cyber Shadow. It's probably going to go a bit unnoticed amid all the other retro-style 8-bit games. Very reminiscent of about five of them: Ninja Gaiden, Mega Man. And as I was just saying, the old Castlevania Symphony of the Night instincts kicked right in there, but it's quite intuitive. I'd play more of it. Passes the time. So tell us a bit about Phoenix Point. It's looking very XCOM-y at first glance.
It is, yes. Phoenix Point is created by Julian Gollop, who is the creator of the original XCOM. So.
I thought it was. I heard he was making something like this.
Yeah, so that's why it certainly wears its XCOM heritage on its sleeve. And it's a bit of a hybrid between sort of the old school XCOM style games, so the original UFO, Terror from the Deep, Apocalypse also plays quite a significant role in the strategy layer. But it also takes some stuff from the modern sort of Firaxis remakes as well.
I'd normally play this with a mouse.
Yeah, you and me both.
That was quite fun. We talked about the story, and all I was hearing was it's XCOM again, but it's mutants instead of aliens this time. It's one from the conference, the old Spiritfarer.
We say that Spiritfarer is a cozy management game about dying.
Okay.
Basically, you play as Stella, the girl here, who's been newly appointed new Fairy Master to the deceased, so her role is to build a boat, upgrade it, and then pick up spirits to be able to be released into the afterlife.
I like the animation, I must say.
Thank you very much. It's first a management game, so you have to farm, mine, go into places to, you know, find resources and gather them, and then spend them and invest them into the boat and all the activities you have aboard as well.
Yeah, not so bad. Good, well animated. It seems like it would bore the shit out of me after a while, but your kids might like it. Seems like there's a growing market for that sort of, like, low-end management sort of game. I think that's all I could say about it, really. I guess that's the last thing we're going to be able to play, because it's closing, like, now. So, well, that wasn't too bad. I played a grand total of 5 games at this showcase. I was trying to think of a good sign-off line. This was Yahtzee at the Microsoft Showcase. Here at E3, the show that persists in spite of no one really wanting to be here. Thanks.